Well, good evening, everyone, and a chance, first of all, here to see the Russell Cyclone cheerleaders and the mini cheerleaders, some of the future cheerleaders for the Cyclones. Let's listen in. Those youngsters, of course, many of them aspiring in the years ahead to be a part of the Cyclone cheerleading squad. Gonna have a little dance routine now. As you heard the public address announcer say, the Cyclone cheerleaders and the mini cheerleaders here at Cyclone Stadium. Great to have you with us, North Little Rock. They're posing for some pictures now. North Little Rock, the opponent, as the conference season begins for the Cyclones this evening. Russellville coming off a huge victory over previous number one Fayetteville. Of course, on a high note now, riding high as they enter what's the really important part of the season, the conference campaign. And North Little Rock always a tough, tough opponent for the Cyclones. Coaching staff slowly making their way to the field. There are some of the officials and the co-captains for tonight's game. There's Marcus Kitchens, Kenneth Golden, as they prepare for tonight's game. Jason Walker is number 20. And, of course, number 89 is Terrell Carter, the four captains for the Cyclones. Beautiful evening here at Cyclone Stadium. Set to come out onto the field for the toss of the coin. Right at the 50-yard line, and, of course, Russellville, the only thing that you worry about a little bit coming into this game is, can the Cyclones get up again emotionally and at the same type of a spirited level as they played against the Fayetteville Bulldogs? And of course, they just about need to, because as we mentioned a moment ago, this is the important part of the season, that being the conference campaign. If you want to play in the state playoffs, it's the conference campaign that makes all the difference. So now we'll have the toss of the coin, see how this one is going to shake out for the beginning of the game. Our ground level camera puts you right into the huddle. You can't even be at the game and in the stands and get a better seat than you're seeing right now. There on your right is Bill McKelvey, and he's the honorary co-captain this evening for the Cyclones from the Cyclone Booster Club. It appeared the Cyclones won the toss. They tapped Terrell Carter on the shoulder. So North Little Rock will be defending the North goal, and they will receive to begin the ball game. Russell will be on defense. Everybody shakes hands, and we're just about ready for tonight's football game. Quick look there. You saw just a glance into the stands. Good crowd here tonight as, of course, the Cyclones. The fans, of course, excited about the possibilities now as the Cyclones have run out to an undefeated start at 3-0 on the year in their non-conference schedule. And hopeful of continuing with a victory tonight here at home to start the conference campaign. Now there Tom Posey is presenting to Bill McKelvey, and Sheila is his wife, a special award for their work with the Russellville Cyclone Booster Club. Back in a moment.
Danny Cawthorn wants to be your next Polk County Sheriff. He has 16 years of law enforcement background and experience, was hired as a Polk County deputy in 1974, is a Vietnam veteran who served with the 101st Airborne, the owner of a successful Polk County small business. Danny Cawthorn, your choice for Polk County Sheriff.
Hi, I'm Danny Cawthorn, and I'd like to be your next sheriff.
We want you to vote for Danny.
Have you looked closely at the rate on your interest-bearing checking account? What about the account benefits? Are you getting the rewards you deserve? Maybe it's time to check out reward checking, offered exclusively at First State Bank, the only bank in the market paying higher interest checking. Plus, you get same-day posting and refunds on your foreign ATM fees. We'll also include free online banking with bill pay. Don't settle for second-best checking when you can have reward checking from First State Bank, your true community bank.
Two free throws. Out to Smith. Brown, 11 points, 7 rebounds in the contest. Smith lost it going inside. Now it's Martin. Blew the dunk. Ball tipped away by Smith.
Back and down. No defensive help.
Life comes at you fast. With our select coverage options, a nationwide agent can tailor a home policy just for you.
Contact Chris Lamberson at 968-8698.
Oh, the cheerleaders are ready. The Cyclones will be inside that tunnel, and in just a moment, it'll start to rockin', it'll start to smokin'. And there's North Little Rock coming onto the field on the far sideline, but you'll start to see the Cyclones come out of that tunnelway here in just a moment. The smoke will begin to filter from underneath that tunnel. And then they will come bursting onto the field. As you hear the band in the background, there come the Cyclones into the back of the Cyclone Tunnel. So in just a moment, it will begin to do that jumping and bouncing and the smoke coming from underneath it. There is the smoke, which means that Cyclone is about to burst forth here for the Cyclones. And here come the Cyclones onto the field. As usual, number 11, Marcus Kitchens, leads the Cyclones onto the field, and I think the Cyclones have surprised a few people already this year and are hopeful of making a few more believers tonight, particularly of the North Little Rock Charging Wildcats. So the Cyclones will huddle in the south end zone for a final prayer before they begin tonight's football game. You hear the Cyclone band in the background. Want to, of course, thank our great sponsors who are with us throughout the campaign: Sorrell's Body Shop Incorporated, Liberty Bank, Energy, Innovative Industrial Solutions Incorporated, Turnkey Business Systems, Posey Printing and Marketing Incorporated, Simmons Bank, Valley Motors Incorporated, EADS North America, Doctors Johnston and Richardson, and St. Mary's Regional Medical Center. IMC Studios Sportswatch Channel 6 bring you the Cyclone football games throughout the 2008 season. Cyclones will kick off. Head coach Jeff Holt gave his last instructions to his Cyclones. And number 18, of course, is Zach Hocker, who will tee up the football near the center of the field. And we're just moments away from getting this football game underway. Boy, there you can feel the electricity in the air. The Cyclone black helmets are held high aloft to begin this football game. The band, of course, keeping the chant going. And the Cyclones ready to kick off. Hocker approaches the football, and this one is underway. And this one's going to be returned at the 5-yard line. Right straight up the middle of the field, but not much to the 20. The return from senior Donald James, number 21, 5'9", 170. And the return out to the 20-yard line. Hocker has been consistently putting the kickoffs into the end zone. And this one just about the same result, because the return of James was right to the 20-yard line. So the same result, as North Little Rock up to the line of scrimmage, usually big and strong, like to pound the football right at you. Give it off to the tailback on first down, slips to the outside, but not much there, maybe a yard. Carrying the football was number 8, Michael Tillman. Let's look at it again on instant replay from our ground level camera. He tries to slide to the outside, but not much there. Ooh, and there's a big tackle by number 99, David Stewart. That's 6'4", 327 pounds. But also give credit to Addison Walker, number 44, for turning that play back inside. Gain of 1, second down and 9. The quarterback is David Hope. Give it off to the tailback, sweeps left, and boy, he has met in the hole and dropped after maybe a yard or two gain. Josh Morosco, number 3, made the stop with a good heads-up tackle, gain of 2. Brings up 3rd down and 7. Again, North Little Rock, they rely on the running game. They will throw the football, but they like a little more traditional. They're not quite the spread offense that a lot of teams have gone to. Rolling to the side. Oh, Terrell Carter almost got the quarterback for a loss. And that one knocked away at the last second. Bradford Webb over there, number 1. Look at Terrell Carter, almost has the quarterback sack there, but just got past him. Throws and knocked away there brilliantly by Bradford Webb. The pass was intended out there for the wide receiver for North Little Rock. Looked like it was James Shearing. Sheerans. And now the punt away. And the catch. Sliding to the catch was David Robinson following the fair catch signal, but good field position for the Cyclones as they'll get it at their own 46-yard line. This good offensive unit for the Cyclones. And that's where they will start first down and 10. Steven Gebhardt already split out to the near side, David Robinson to the far side. And how many circus catches has David Robinson already made for the Cyclones this season? Your quarterback, Barrett Hughes, gives it off to the tailback, Golden. Golden finds some running room into North Little Rock territory, keeps going, kept his head down, and almost has it up for a first down. Let's look at it again on instant replay. Just a good straight-ahead handoff, but good up front blocking. Slides to the outside just a little bit. The cutback is great. And finally, bumped down. Second effort there. And finally, ridden down at the 45-yard line of North Little Rock. First man there to bump him was number 80, the defensive end, Ryan Franklin, but he couldn't bring him down. Twin receivers to the near side. That's the wide side of the field. Golden gets the handoff, sidesteps two different players, but couldn't get past that second one. And on the stop was number 24. That is Brian McCleary, defensive end, 6'2", 120 pounds. No gain on the play, really. Third down and still a yard to go at the 45 of North Little Rock. No score, first period from Cyclone Stadium. First conference game of the year, Cyclones undefeated. And riding in high after a defeat of previous number one, the Fayetteville Bulldogs. Bring a man in motion. That's Keeling. Now he retreats. Hand off once again. And the first down and plenty more for Kenneth Golden. And he has such great vision to find the hole and then accelerate through it. The gain to nearly the 40-yard line. It's first down for the Cyclones in North Little Rock territory. We'll call it the 40 and a half, just to be more precise. Gebhardt goes split right. Near side is David Robinson from the shotgun now with twin backs in the backfield. Coming to the near side. Oh, Golden says, nope, where am I going to go now? And now he's just going to try to get out of bounds. That one just did not have anywhere to go. Over there, once again, was Shearing. Helped out by Brian McCleary, once again, number 24. And so the loss is about five on the play, back to the 45-yard line, second and 15. Twin receivers are split right and twins to the left. Only a single setback in the backfield with Barrett Hughes now. This is a good defensive unit from North Little Rock, to say the least. Hughes going to step up. Now throws, and was it complete? If it is, no, he said not complete, incomplete. Intended for Stephen Gebhardt at the 39-yard line. It wouldn't have been but a one-yard pickup on the play, or about a six-yard pickup on the play. It would have been the 5 yards lost previously, plus a yard to the good to the 39, but incomplete. Into the ball game for the Cyclones. Derek Haley, number four, he split in the slot right. And Hughes from the shotgun. Now he splits Golden outright, making it trips right. Hughes barking those signals. Wants to throw, has to throw in a hurry. Incomplete. Intended for Stephen Gebhardt down around the 35-yard line, but pressure on Barrett Hughes to release that football as one of the defensive backs for North Little Rock came in there untouched. And so Hughes had to unload the football quickly. So the punting situation for Russellville from the 45 should pin North Little Rock deep in their own territory midway through the first quarter with no score. Donald James back defensively to receive this kick. And he stays away from it. He thought about it there for a moment, but the ball is downed at the 15-yard line. Over there for the Cyclones, Jared Vinson, number 45. And North Little Rock, which began its first series at its own 20, now starts at its own between the 15 and the 16-yard line. From the 16, North Little Rock, quarterback again, David Hope, who's a 5'7", 180-pounder. Has the I formation behind him with a split receiver both left and to the wide side of the field, which is right. Give it to the tailback, and he slides out to about the 19, maybe the 20-yard line. Jared Vinson is there. Again, the ball carrier is Michael Tillman. He's a 175-pound running back. Got underneath some of the Cyclone defenders that time. Pick up a 5, second and 5. Going split left, Donald James, number 21. Hope. Quick pitches, right. And, Josh Marasco stood him up once again. That is Michael Tillman. Just about a yard gain on that play. Let's look at it again. As the Cyclones pitch it to the outside, Terrell Carter forces him to the outside. And look at there, are three red shirts right there. Not much hope. Jared Vinson at the bottom of that pile. Not much help for Tillman as the Cyclone defense pursuing that play tremendously at the 21-yard line. Twin receivers left and twin right as now North Little Rock will go from the spread and from the shotgun. Hope looks, fires back left, and it's caught. Nice reception there, turned in by the wide receiver Darius Walton, number 83. And that'll be enough for a first down. He had to go up high for that particular grab, and the six-footer able to reach up for the first down grab. Football resting at the 28-yard line. Give it straight ahead, and again, number 8 is Michael Tillman. But not, boy, the running is tough between the tackles. Marcus Kitchens gets up last off that pile of red and black clad Cyclones. No gain on the play, second down and 10. Well, maybe we give him a yard on forward progress. Call it second and 9. This time you see Tillman in the slot right. Gives it off to the slot back around to the 40, 45, and out to the 48-yard line. That is Devontae Rich. Coming from the slot. And that is a carry out to the 48-yard line. Nice pickup. Best offensive play of the night for North Little Rock. And about a 15-yard pickup. So a nice bit of play calling there. Brad Boulding is the head coach for North Little Rock. Hope with single setback. One step, throws, and incomplete. Was a little high, and it was intended for wide receiver Donald James. Incomplete. Just one step drop and a quick throw on the out pattern, but a little high. So at the 48-yard line, the play comes in from wide receiver D'Angelo Mabry, number 11. And the charging Wildcats will have a wide receiver left, way wide left, right in front of the North Little Rock bench. Give it off to Tillman. Oh, Tillman, nothing there. Boy, he hit a stone wall. That's Trent Leslie, number 41. And there's just not a whole lot of running room against that front wall of the Cyclones. Gain to the 50-yard line. Trent Leslie is 6'2 and 205. And tell you what, when Tillman went left, he had a pretty good head of steam, and we see a hanky down on the turf here at Cyclone Stadium. Let's see what the officials are going to tell us about. They pick up the hanky. So there was a motion to kind of warn the sidelines to move back on the North Little Rock side, so maybe that's what the flag was thrown about. They did not mark off a penalty. Third down and eight, or all, better than eight, almost nine. Up to the line of scrimmage, wide receiver left, that's the narrow side of the field now. And Hope, quick pitch left to Tillman. Tillman sweeping, and he is bumped out of bounds by Lucas Frazee, well short of the first down yardage. And I'll tell you what, there's a young man also in Frazee, 5'9", 160, who will ring your bell. Here comes Tillman, and boom, he's not going forward much more. He went right into his own bench. Lowered that shoulder and quite a bit short of the first down. So a punting situation for North Little Rock, just into Cyclone territory, marking it at the 47-yard line. The kick away, and Robinson's going to have a return this time, but not much. About 2 yards on the return. He is dropped by number 14, Cody Guthrie, a defensive back, and we've got a flag on the play. You see the yellow napkin on the turf right there. So the officials will talk it over. They didn't have to talk long. Face mask is the penalty against North Little Rock. And oh, it is the personal foul variety, not the inadvertent. Moves it out to the 32. That really helps the Cyclones. Turns a 2-yard return into the same thing as a 17-yard return. And moves the Cyclones out of a hole. Haley in the slot near side. I believe that's Gebhardt also split left. Single set back in the backfield for Barrett Hughes. Neither team has been able to do much offensively. Hand it off. And here comes Golden. He broke one tackle and was able to pick up 3 or 4 yards. Really went over the back of one of the defenders. And that was the defensive end, Ryan Franklin. Number 80. So the pickup is 5, second and 5, football 37-yard line as David Robinson goes split to the right-hand side. Here's Haley and Gebhardt back to the near side. First quarter and not much happening except for the defenses so far. Give it off to Golden, and he almost broke free, got across the 40, should be close to the first down after that pickup. And it's really tough down in the trenches right now. It's going to be close enough for a measurement, the officials say. Both teams trying to run between the tackles, but not able to do a whole lot. Not much success there. They bring the chains in, and the stretch is on. And, oh boy, that's a first down, but just by an eyelash. So for Russellville, first down at their own 42. Cyclones coming in undefeated. A quality victory over Fayetteville last week by 2 touchdowns, and at one point had Fayetteville down 35-7. And it would really be a feather in their cap if they can turn around and now beat a Central Arkansas and conference opponent in their conference opener. Straight eye formation for the Cyclones. Play action fake. Hughes throws downfield. Almost intercepted. Closest man was defensive back Cody Guthrie, number 14. Good idea, but just couldn't connect with the wide receiver. As they play, they had play action there. Faking the handoff to Golden. And Hughes throwing. The coaches trying to analyze things there on the sidelines. Twin receivers near side and twin also right for the Cyclone. Single setback in the backfield. Hughes looks to the sideline. Now switches Golden from right to left. Throw it out of the backfield. That's to Haley, and Haley's... Oh, he broke the tackle, 50, and down the near sideline. There were two defenders over there, and somehow they missed Mr. Haley. Coming to the near side, there's Haley down the sideline, and finally bumped out of bounds. 46-yard line is where they said he stepped out of bounds initially. Third down coming up. Still about six. Trips right. You see them like a ladder out there to the top of your screen. Looking. Hughes under pressure. Throws. Almost intercepted once again. Intended for Stephen Gebhard. And the throw just a little bit late on the break there. The defender was over there in good shape to knock it free at the 46. So you see the defenses have been dominating here in the first quarter. There's no score. So the Cyclones will punt the football away once again with Zach Hocker. And back is Donald James. Almost got the kicker on that play. And oh man, the defensive back was really submerged. You can see right there into the kicker, and there's James to receive the kick, and he's about to get KO'd. Kaboom! And he is wrestled to the ground there by John Olson. So there's the hanky, and that could be either roughing the kicker or running into the kicker, and there were some good licks on either side. There's Hocker on the near sideline. And the penalty against North Little Rock for roughing the kicker. And now they'll mark it off from the 46. And there it is, 15 yards. That's a personal foul. And that's a first down for the Cyclones and keeps this drive alive. So it moves it to the 39-yard line. First down and 10, Cyclones, late first quarter. Hughes still has Kenneth Golden in the backfield. Twins right, split. Give it off Golden, cuts it back. Tough running, but a couple of tough yards there. At the bottom of that pile, number 45, Mark Spate, 6'1", 190. He's a linebacker on that side for the charging Wildcats. Gained to the 37-yard line. As Russellville with the deepest penetration for either team so far in the football game. Twins in the backfield surrounding Barrett Hughes. Steps up, almost got sacked. Now lost the pass up, and it's complete to Robinson. He scores. And again, David Robinson pulls one of those elusive moves that he has become famous for. Let's look at it again. And look at how close Hughes gets to being tackled here. Whoops. And finally releases it. That was 91 Colt Schaller. And just over the outreached hands of the defensive back and Robinson in for the touchdown. The defensive back on that side was Christian Hooks. But you talk about under duress. Again, Colt Schaller was the defender who almost brought Barrett Hughes down. He got away from that. The extra point kick being good. Got away from that defensive rush. Set himself. Became poised. And threw the strike to David Robinson. Beyond the defender for the Cyclone touchdown. And it's 7-0. Back in a moment.
Want more life per gallon? Then Valley Motors is your best buy. With over one-third of our pre-owned inventory getting 30 miles per gallon and cars and trucks beginning at only $178 per month, it is a win-win situation for you. Plus, Valley Motors' goal is to finance everyone with the best rates, the best warranties, and the peace of mind in buying a quality certified pre-owned vehicle. That's Valley Motors, Highway 64 East in Russellville. Your friends in the car business.
So how do you like driving that thing?
It's intense.
Expensive to insure?
No. Went with Nationwide, saved like $500.
$500?
Yeah, it's great coverage.
Really? I didn't know Nationwide did that.
Life comes at you fast. With Nationwide, you could save like $500 on your auto insurance.
Contact Chris Lamberson at 968-8698.
Nationwide is on your side.
Huh.
Shop for a cause at Mistletoe Market, a holiday shopping event benefiting the Boys and Girls Clubs of the River Valley. Friday and Saturday, October 10th and 11th, from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. at the L.V. Williamson Boys and Girls Club in Russellville. Call 968-7819.
Are you ready to score a touchdown on a new Toyota? I'm Randy Cox of Phil Wright Toyota in Russellville. And if you want to shop at a dealership where you have a comfortable, hometown atmosphere,
where you are treated with respect and allowed to make an intelligent decision about the car that is right for your needs without being pushed,
where we never have any bogus charges just for doing your paperwork,
a dealership that offers great prices without all the tricky advertising gimmicks.
Come see Joel, Michael, or Heath, or visit us online at www.philwrighttoyota.com.
CenturyTel high-speed internet, $14.95 a month when you bundle. Think fast.
.135 left to go, first period, and a good start for the Cyclones. Lead 7-0. 37 yards on the scoring strike. And again, you have the feeling that those defensive backs started to come up once that Barrett Hughes had eluded the defensive end, Colt Schaller. So they were coming up to support the scramble. And when Hughes saw that, he pulled up, set himself, had enough presence of mind to find David Robinson on the near sideline, got it over the defensive back who had come up, Christian Hooks. And from that point on, David Robinson did the rest. 7-0. As the Cyclones are trying to win their first conference game of the year. Hocker drives that football. Boy, this one's not coming back. 5 yards deep into the end zone. It's a touchback. Can't be run out in high school. And that's where North Little Rock will start at their own 20-yard line. And this is familiar to the charging Wildcats. They have been here twice before. So final moments, period number one. You see our great sponsors. Their name is being flashed in the lower left-hand side of your screen. Remember them, please, because of them, that's why we can bring you these telecasts every week, supporting these, not only the football team, but the band, the cheerleaders, and Russellville High School itself. Give it off, first man through. Pickup of about two or three. You see Trent Leslie there. And carrying the football was Hakario Miles, number 47. Hakario Miles, he's 5'10", 165, number 47. The gain to the 23-yard line, second down and seven. Again, Twin sets in the backfield along with Hope, the quarterback who's in the shotgun. Up, and they're going to stop play. Oh, man, and Trent Leslie just leveled Miles. The Cyclones are clapping, particularly big David Stewart, so it must be against the charging Wildcats. It's a false start. The official almost pointed the wrong way. He says move the football back 5 yards, which they will, to the 18. So it should be repeating second down and 12. From the 18-yard line, Russ leads 7-0. Final seconds of period number one. Going wide left, Darius Walton, number 83. Twin receivers in the backfield, along with the quarterback, Hope. He's under pressure, throws back. It's a big screen pass, and that's Tillman, able to elude Big David Stewart, but not able to get past Josh Marosco, number 3. Cyclone Rush was on. They had the blitz on. They throw the screen pass, which is a good idea, but David Stewart just about slowed up Tillman there, and then Marosco was out there playing the right place and drug him down by the jersey. He had help. So that screen pass just did not have any place to go. Back to the 16-yard line. That's the end of the first quarter. The Russellville Cyclones leading the North Little Rock Charging Wildcats 7-0. We'll be right back.
Though I've been actively involved in public service for several years, I find that family life plays a critical role in preparing me to be your state representative. Families deal with budgets every day, and things like jobs and safety are paramount to us. We know education is the key to success, and that we all have to work together for the good of all.
Families, they can teach us a lot about the right paths in life. As your next state representative, I'll bring my collective public service and practical experience to the state capitol.
I'm back in my old school to talk about Suddenlink digital cable and high-speed internet.
That's my fifth grade teacher, Mrs. Panucci.
Michael, you still owe me that paper on horseshoe crabs.
Sure thing, Mrs. Panucci, but right now I'm giving an oral presentation about Suddenlink. There's tons of educational shows, and their internet speeds are the fastest in town.
Michael!
I gotta go, but call Suddenlink.
Get Suddenlink 4 meg preferred high-speed internet. Now only $29.95 a month for your first 4 months.
Cars have changed a lot over the years. If your pride and joy has been in an accident or just needs restoration, you need a team of specialists with the up-to-date knowledge and equipment to do the job right. At Advanced Collision Solutions, our team is certified as iCar Gold Class professionals to restore all kinds of vehicles, from antiques to RVs, and we guarantee our service with a lifetime warranty. So choose the right solution. Choose Advanced Collision Solutions.
Head coach Jeff Holt and his coaching staff welcome the defensive unit back to the sideline. Good job they have done so far in this ball game. They have put a lot of pressure on that offensive unit from North Little Rock, and the offensive line from North Little Rock has not been able to hold out the Cyclones so far. The running backs have not had much running room to run, and the quarterback, David Hope, has not had any time to throw the football the few times he has attempted to. But it's mainly been a running attack from North Little Rock, and it is netted next to zero for the Charging Wildcats. But that is a very good defensive unit for the Cyclones. You have Marcus Kitchens, you got Terrell Carter, Josh Marosco, Lucas Frey. I mean, the list just goes on and on. And we have some new kids to talk about, too, when we have Big David Stewart, number 99, in the ball game. We also have people like John Olson and Bobby Goins. Some good names to talk about. This unit has really come together with some good senior leadership and some young fireballs that are in there right now. There's Hope from the shotgun. Looking at a possible blitz there from Russell. They don't do it. Throw downfield and incomplete. That was intended for the wide receiver. That is Darius Walton. Incomplete. So North Little Rock will have to throw the football in the form of a punt this time. On fourth down, Russ will lead 7-0, scoring on a 37-yard pass play from Barrett Hughes to David Robinson. So we're awaiting the punt to head skyward, and there it is. And David Robinson says, I want a fairer catch, which he takes at his own 46-yard line. First down and 10 for the Cyclones, leading 7-0, second quarter underway. You see Kenneth Golden checking in, Tanner Keeling. And that offensive line, anchored by Logan Humphrey, the senior 250-pounder. We see in the backfield now number 26, Jacob Sparks, the junior. And he, along with Stephen Gebhardt and David Robinson, go split left. From the 47-yard line, they flip-flop, and now they put Sparks in the backfield. And they give it to him. And he responds across the 50 to the 49-yard line. The junior tackled by number 4, Colby Miller, the linebacker, 175-pounder. Pick up a 4, 2nd and 6. Jacob Sparks gets his first carry. They then move Kenneth Golden to a wide receiver position with the shift in the backfield. Second quarter, Russell 7, North Little Rock 0. Hughes wants to throw, fires it out. Gives it to Golden, one-on-one, 50 to the 45, and out of bounds about the 40-yard line. Boy, he is quick. Let's look at it again. There come the linemen with the rush, and they throw it out on a little mini screen to Golden. Gets a good block there. Now cuts it to the outside. And finally, diving to get him out of bounds was number 45, Mark Spate, the linebacker, number 45. But that's a first down to the 40-yard line of North Little Rock. Cyclones already leading by a score of 7-0. First down at the charging Wildcat 40-yard line. Twin backs in the backfield surrounding Barrett Hughes. Give it off. And that's Jason Walker, who slid down just as he got inside the 40 to about the 36-yard line. Thought he could have gone further. So the pickup about 3 on the play. 2nd down and 7. Football resting at the 36-yard line. The Russell Cyclones trying to notch victory number 4. 3 wide receivers right. Hughes in the backfield, directing activities from the shotgun. Now flip-flops and brings Sparks back into the backfield once again. They gave it to him the last time they did that. Oh, there's a flag on the play. You heard a whistle, and is that delay of game? You know, it's a timeout for the Cyclones. And with that, we're going to take a little break ourselves. Catch our breath. Exciting ball game, 7-0 Russellville. Back after this.
If you had someone build you a deck, you'd want them to use the best materials. If you had someone build you a pool, you'd want them to use the best materials. If you had someone install your roof, you'd want them to use award-winning GAF materials. Miller Roofing Company is the only GAF-certified roofing company in the River Valley. Miller Roofing Company is the only one that accepts credit cards and offers financing. Don't settle for anything but the best. Don't settle for anyone but Miller Roofing Company, serving the River Valley for over 24 years.
As a kid, we had that encyclopedia from 1976, and I'd be like, why isn't the space shuttle in here? Today's students learn so much on the internet. They listen to famous speeches, and they look at that cat. That's why suddenly high-speed internet's great. There's no required contracts, and with connections that are faster than DSL, you'll know it's not 1976. Now that's groovy.
Get Suddenlink Value High-Speed Internet. Enjoy 1 meg of download speed for only $19.95 a month for your first 4 months.
Danny Cawthorn wants to be your next Polk County Sheriff. He has 16 years of law enforcement background and experience, was hired as a Polk County Deputy in 1974, is a Vietnam veteran who served with the 101st Airborne, the owner of a successful Polk County small business. Danny Cawthorn, your choice for Polk County Sheriff.
Hi, I'm Danny Cawthorn, and I'd like to be your next sheriff.
We want you to vote for Danny.
Life comes at you fast, but with Nationwide Blue Ribbon Claim Services, you don't have to worry if your car's been in an accident.
Contact Chris Lamberson at 968-8698.
Nationwide is on your side.
There you look, on the sideline, right into the huddle. As the coaches talk to the offensive unit. You see Matt Lutz, number 8, also in the lineup. There are the cheerleaders doing their always great job on the Cyclone sideline. And let me tell you, these gals work, put in just as many hours as the band and the football team, drill team. I mean, it's a lot of work besides their schoolwork to prepare for these games. And you hear the band in the background. And across the way, there is the North Little Rock. That's the pep band that came up from North Little Rock. My good friend Bill Spainauer is the band director there. One of the band directors there. From the shotgun. Hand it off. Good move there by the Cyclones and Jason Walker. Good reaction, though, by the defense from North Little Rock. The stop made defensively by big number 72. That is Joey Brown, 215-pounder, a senior. So the football, 35-yard line. 5 yards away from a first down. And again, Barrett Hughes in the shotgun. That's Kenneth Golden to his right. Back, Hughes wants to throw. Lofts it up, gets it there to Keeling. Sidesteps one guy and is knocked down at the 20-yard line. Big hit there by Mark Spate. But look at this pretty play on instant replay. Just a little soft touch pass right there to Keeling coming across. 30, 25, look at how nimbly he got around that defender and then knocked down at the 20. That was almost a dance move there. Maybe he ought to be on Dancing with the Stars. Well, we have an injury timeout. And while we attend to the injured ball player on the field at the 25, we'll take a little break and be right back.
Drugstore, we strive for the best hometown service we can give. Locally owned and operated since the late 1800s, C&D Drugstore is one of the oldest established drugstores in Arkansas. At C&D Drugstore, we accept all Medicare Part D and offer free delivery. We offer custom compounding and custom flavors for all your prescription needs. So come let our highly trained pharmacy staff assist you and enjoy the snack bar while you wait. C&D Drugstore, 968-2456.
Have you looked closely at the rate on your interest-bearing checking account? What about the account benefits? Are you getting the rewards you deserve? Maybe it's time to check out reward checking, offered exclusively at First State Bank, the only bank in the market paying higher interest checking. Plus, you get same-day posting and refunds on your foreign ATM fees. We'll also include free online banking with bill pay. Don't settle for second-best checking when you can have reward checking from First State Bank, your true community bank.
Are you ready to score a touchdown on the new Toyota? I'm Randy Cox, Phil Wright Toyota in Russellville. And if you want to shop at a dealership where you have a comfortable hometown atmosphere,
where you're treated with respect and allowed to make an intelligent decision about the car that is right for your needs without being pushed,
where we never have any bogus charges just for doing your paperwork,
a dealership that offers great prices without all the tricky advertising gimmicks,
come see Joel, Michael, or Heath, or visit us online at www.philwrighttoyota.com.
So the injured North Little Rock player has taken off the sideline. We hope it's not anything serious. But boy, that was quite a move. I mean, it was almost a ballet pirouette there from Tanner Keeling. I didn't know that 250 pounds could be as graceful as that. I'll have to ask him about that. Mm-hmm. Barrett Hughes is under center. Play action. Rolling right. Throwing. And it's caught by Keeling again, this time to the 10-yard line. Good reaction from Keeling. He had to wait for the ball to be tipped. Finally brought down defensively by Christian Hooks, number 30. Look at it again from ground level. Play action. The fake to Golden, who then blocks. Throw out of the backfield is tipped, and Keeling reacts to the play and works his way forward. The tip came from linebacker Colby Miller, number 4. So two nimble plays in a row from the big fullback. Hughes. Single setback is Kenneth Golden. Gives it off. Golden, not much there. Tried to sidestep a couple of people, but the pursuit caught up to him. Defensive lineman Anthony Rogers, 6'4", 225, made the stop, number 53. But it's enough for a first down. Even though it was just a yard pickup, and the gain inside the 10. So the Cyclones have a first and goal, leading 7-0 midway through the second quarter. This game a lot more ground-oriented than the wide-open passing game we had a week ago with Fayetteville. Both teams passing the football a lot. This is a tough place on the field, first and goal at the 9. And they give it off to Golden, and Golden, he turned that one around, down to the 3-yard line. Making the stop, Christian Hooks. Let's look at it again. Finds that crease. And finally works his way to the 4, maybe the 3-yard line. Nice job of the offensive line there, sealing that hole. So it's between the 3 and the 4. For Russellville, trying to make this a 13 or 14-0 ball game. Give it off. Here's Golden. He's going to try to get around the left side, and he was dropped for a loss back at the 6. Tried to outrun the North Little Rock defenders, but with the angle on him was Mark Spate, number 45. So a 3-yard loss on the play, that time back to the 6-yard line. So we're back in a tough situation here. Outside the 5, and it's goal to goal. Trips right, the wide side of the field. Barrett Hughes looks right, now lofts it up, has a man, but David Robinson, well, he could have caught it, but he would have been out of bounds anyway. Was thrown just a little bit wide, and he was wide open on the near side. That would be the west side of the end zone, and it's 4th down. So Zach Hocker will check in, try to tag on a field goal here. And they'll place it down. Looks like the 14-yard line, 13-yard line, which would be a 23 or 24-yard field goal. Snap down, the kick is up. And the kick, it is good. So Russellville widens its lead to a 10-0 score midway through the second quarter. 6:24 to go. Back in a moment.
It's really cute. Don't you love the sunroof?
Yeah, especially this time of year.
How's the insurance on it?
You won't believe. I went with Nationwide and saved like $500.
$500?
Yeah. Coverage is great.
Huh. I didn't know Nationwide did that.
Life comes at you fast. With Nationwide, you could save like $500 on your auto insurance.
Contact Chris Lamberson at 968-8698.
Nationwide is on your side.
Uh-huh.
When you're looking for a pre-owned vehicle, Valley Motors offers the best selection in the River Valley. Only the cleanest vehicles that have passed the Carfax report and are silver-certified 70-point inspection are waiting for you. Plus, we have a large selection of vehicles getting 30 miles per gallon or more. Knowledgeable, friendly salespeople, the best selection, prices starting at $49.95, and easy financing are all at Valley Motors Pre-Owned Center, your friends in the car business. Highway 64 East in Russellville.
If you had someone build you a deck, you'd want them to use the best materials. If you had someone build you a pool, you'd want them to use the best materials. If you had someone install your roof, you'd want them to use award-winning GAF materials. Miller Roofing Company is the only GAF-certified roofing company in the River Valley. Miller Roofing Company is the only one that accepts credit cards and offers financing. Don't settle for anything but the best. Don't settle for anyone but Miller Roofing Company, serving the River Valley for over 24 years.
Though I've been actively involved in public service for several years, I find that family life plays a critical role in preparing me to be your state representative. Families deal with budgets every day, and things like jobs and safety are paramount to us. We know education is the key to success, and that we all have to work together for the good of all.
Families, they can teach us a lot about the right paths in life. As your next state representative, I'll bring my collective public service and practical experience to the state capitol.
Well, that looks good on the scoreboard here. Midway through period number 2, 10-0 in favor of the Russellville Cyclones. There's the Cyclone Band. You see pride on the back of their t-shirts. As the Cyclones have done all there has been tonight offensively, there hasn't been a whole lot of offense. But what there has been from the Cyclones in North. Little Rock has had next to nothing. Good job by the Cyclone defense so far tonight here in the first half. So Russellville, Zach Hocker will be kicking this time from north to south. Let's see if he can put it in the end zone from this position. Three deep receivers for North Little Rock. The charging Wildcats. Again, we mentioned this is so important as the conference opener. You want that conference championship. You want trip to the state playoffs. It all begins here tonight. And there's the kick, and that one's going down, going to be taken. No, he put his back foot into the end zone. I was going to see whether or not they ruled that when he braced to catch the football, he moved that foot back into the end zone, and that is an automatic touchback. Out to the 20. Either the third or fourth time this first half that North Little Rock has begun at their own 20-yard line, 80 yards away. Cyclones, by and large, have had the short field, either near midfield or in North Little Rock territory when they've begun their drives. So field position so much an important part of this game. Hope at quarterback. Gave it off to the first man through. Not much going there for Jamar Davis, the running back, 5'6", 170. And he's the short back in that kind of short eye. It's almost as though there's a fullback, but no tailback in that formation. And so he gave it to him on the quick handoff. And you have to be so concerned about whether he keeps it and gives it to the halfback coming around that sometimes you miss that first man in the option. So they run that same. That's a double slot formation. This time they give it to the tailback, and he doesn't get anywhere at all. That's Devontae Rich. Let's look at it again. This one kind of developed slow anyway. Hand it off to Devontae Rich. He's slowed up by Marcus Kitchens, and then he is met in the hole by Bradford Webb, number one. So not much doing there. Football is at the 25-yard line. Still 5 yards away from a North Little Rock first down. Back, Hope throws, and it's a little bit high. And thrown into traffic. Pass was intended for Ryan Franklin, who's playing both ways this evening as a tight end and a defensive end. Number 80. Incomplete on the pass. And the charging Wildcats are faced with a 4th down and 5. Having to punt the football away once again to the Cyclones. And the Cyclones should have pretty good field position. There's David Robinson, ready for a possible return. And the kick. And it's going to take nice. It's a nice kick. It hits and rolls sideways away from the receiver about the 38-yard line of Russellville. And that'll be the poorest field position in a while for the Cyclones. There is Big David Stewart. Boy, 6'4", 327. He is a big clog in that defensive front when the Cyclones are on defense. Hard to move that guy out of the way. Twins left, including Haley. He's in the slot. Here's Keeling, the acrobatic. Mr. Tanner Keeling in the slot to the near side. Hughes gives it off. Golden out to the 41, maybe the 42-yard line. Big number 79 there to make the stop. And that is Darius Hudson. 5'11", 330 pounds. You don't want him falling on you. So a gain of 3, 2nd down and 7. David Robinson split to the far side. Twin receivers to the near side. From the shotgun. Hughes went over quickly to make an adjustment. Takes the snap, gives it off to Golden, and whatever the adjustment was, it was wrong. Stop made defensively by number 91, Colt Schaller. Number 91, 6'3", 225 in the defensive line. Lost back outside the 40, which would be about the 39-yard line the Cyclones own. So it's 3rd down and 9. Gebhardt and Robinson near side, and they're joined by Haley. Derek Haley, the 6-foot senior. Hughes. Looks. Now, doesn't have anybody to throw to. Throws it out incomplete. Kind of threw it to an open area. Gebhardt was the intended receiver. And he gets a little bit of on-the-field instruction from his head coach, Jeff Holt. As Hughes really had no place to go. He wanted to go downfield, and apparently it was covered. So Zach Cocker will have to punt the football away here. Late in the first half, Russellville 10, North Little Rock 0. And there's Donald James once again, ready to return the Hocker punt, if he can. There's a driving kick, and they're going to let it roll. It's going to take a Cyclone roll and then die. About the 25-yard line. Lucas Frazee touched the football down. At the 25, North Little Rock with the football. Late stages of the first half here at Cyclone Stadium in Russellville leading 10-0. 24-yard field goal from Zach Cocker and a 37-yard touchdown from Barrett Hughes to David Robinson. Those are the scores of the ball game so far to this point. Twin receivers go right. Now in the backfield is Jamar Davis. We'd seen Tillman earlier, but now Davis in the backfield. Whoop, dropped by Hope. He's under pressure. Oh, he took a hit. And the pass is caught, however, by James, and it's a first down. Out to the 37-yard line. Terrell Carter over there, helped out by Bobby Goins. But it's enough for a first down, and you got to give a lot of credit to the quarterback, David Hope. He was really tattooed as he released the football, but nice catch by Donald James and the advance for the first down. Twin receivers, both left and right. Shotgun. Hope, under pressure. Oh, he is crushed by Terrell Carter. Boy, oh boy, you saw this one coming, but David Hope did not. Boom, right there. And unfortunately, on that side, the offensive back, who was Jamar Davis, he took Jared Vinson instead of Terrell Carter. He had to block one of them. He did block Jared Vinson, but he did not block Terrell Carter, and Carter lowered the boom on Hope. Fired out of the backfield. That's complete to James, and James to the 32, maybe the 33-yard line. Stop made defensively for the Cyclones by Chase Wetzel, number 27. Gain there about a yard to the 32, a little outside the 32-yard line. 10-0 our score late first half. Number 11, D'Angelo Mabry, goes split right along with two of his teammates for trips wide right. Hope. Oh, he gets leveled again. The throw. Boy, what a catch. That was one heck of a catch in front of Wetzel. There wasn't anything Wetzel could do. One-handed catch by Darius Walden. That was a beautiful catch, and Hope was really pasted as he released the football. Gained to the 28-yard line. First down for North Little Rock, but let me tell you, the grab, unbelievable from Darius Walton, one-handed, and then he wrapped it around his body to where it would be out of harm's way. Nothing Wetzel could do about that. That was just a great athletic play. Pass tipped and taken by Vinson, returns to the 50, to the 40, 30, drug down. Finally, from behind, the old tip drill does it again, and making the stop was number 64, Jonathan Wilson. Here's the pass. Hope throws. It was kind of flat, tipped up in the air, and Vincent comes down with it, comes up the near sideline. And I wouldn't want to be in front of him. Hope makes a futile attempt to try to stop him near the 50. Now back to the 40-yard line, still on his feet. And the offensive lineman, number 64, Jonathan Wilson, finally had to run him down. First down for the Cyclones near the 30-yard line, leading 10-0. Back, Hughes wants to go for all the downs. Downfield, there's Robinson. He's got it. There's a flag on the play, however, but he caught the football. See the clock at 1:01 left to go in the first half. There's a flag on the play. The catch down at the 1-yard line and pass interference against Russellville. Well, we didn't see it, but apparently Robinson may have pushed off. He was able to catch the football on the sideline at the 1-yard line and almost had the touchdown, but this one's coming back. And head coach Jeff Holt having a few words with the official on the near side. He apparently did not agree with that call. So move the football all the way back to the 45-yard line of North Little Rock. Well, that one hurts. Instead of being at the 1-yard line, you're at the 45. And right now, 17-0 going into the halftime locker room would really look sweet. Hughes with a beautiful ball thrown on that last play also. Hughes steps up. Now he's going to have to run for his life. Still on his feet. Throws. Incomplete. Intended for Haley. Coverage over there by Jason Ferry, number 5. And Hughes did a great job just to elude the pressure and avoid a sack. Reminds you of Cowboys and former Navy quarterback Roger Staubach. Breaking tackles, just keeping himself alive. So at the 45, Russell will try to reload again. Leads 10-0. Under a minute to play in the first half. Hughes throws it out. And not a whole lot of room for Kenneth Golden, and he finally is caught up with. Over there defensively, and that one was turned in by Brian McClearly, number 24. We have a flag on the play. Ooh, it's a face mask against Russellville. So the Cyclones going the wrong way here the last minute or so. They talked to the big defensive captain, Darius Hudson, number 79. And you know the officials are going to want to take the yardage on this particular play. Holding. Oh, they make it not face mask, but holding. So back to the 42-yard line of Russellville. Remember that completed pass a moment ago and taking it to the North Little Rock 1. So fortunes have reversed themselves here in the last minute. So Russell from the shotgun. Twin right, twin left. Hughes will want to go right straight down the field. Now the shovel pass, and that did not fool anybody. Got it to Golden, but right there in his face was Colby Miller, the linebacker, number 4. Not much happening there except a yellow flag tossed again. At the 34. Holding against Russell again. Oh, me. So from the 32-yard line, that's going to cost Russell another 10. And again, we remind you the Cyclones were at the 1-yard line after the completed pass that was called back because of offensive pass interference. Now they're back to their own 32. Now you're almost hoping that you can just escape into the halftime locker room. Hand off straight ahead. That's Golden. Sweeps left side. Got some running room. Into the secondary. 50-45 of North Little Rock. The stop made defensively by Mark Spate. So we look at it once again on instant replay. Great job by our great camera crews. Here's Golden. Splits it to the outside. And just a dive there. Turned in by Mark Spate, number 45. Saved that one from going a lot further. There's a break. It's halftime. Back in a moment.
The internet and e-commerce are radically changing the way consumers are spending their money. In fact, a recent U.S. Department of Commerce study shows a 27% increase year over year in internet e-commerce spending, and they expect $117 billion to be spent every year on the internet by 2008. IMC Studios has proven web design and internet e-commerce solutions to help you put your business's products on the internet for a global market. We've been serving the River Valley for over 10 years.
Shop for a cause at Mistletoe Market, a holiday shopping event benefiting the Boys and Girls Clubs of the River Valley. Friday and Saturday, October 10th and 11th from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. at the L.V. Williamson Boys and Girls Club in Russellville. Call 968-7819.
CenturyTel high-speed internet, $14.95 a month when you bundle. Think fast.
Yeah.
please direct your attention to the center of the field where our Russellville High School dance team is preparing to perform. The dance team will be competing with this routine this Saturday in the Paris Dance Invitational. Good luck, ladies. And now, the Russellville High School dance team. Ladies and gentlemen, the Russellville High School Band is now preparing to come onto the field, and we ask that you remain seated and enjoy the halftime show. The superintendent of schools is Mr. Randall Williams, and the principal of Russellville High School is Mr. Wesley White. The band directors are Brad Kaufman, Scott Johnson, and Dwayne Dove. The majorette sponsor is June Drain, and the flag line sponsor is Kendra Wilbanks. The drum majors are Emily Wood and Devin Dove. British Invasion! The Beatles are coming! From the album Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band, tonight's opening selection is Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band and With a Little Help from My Friends. same great album, we now feature clarinets, Danica Ashcraft, Kendall Werner, and Brittany Crosby. Saxophones, Brittany McCowan and Melanie Roach. Trumpets, Anna McWilliams and Emily Trower. Trombones, Ashlyn Campbell and Blake Stokes. Sousaphone, Carl Kreitlein. And percussion, Kaylee Hefner and Alexa Masters. In a Dixieland setting of When I'm 64. Stepping back in time to the very beginning of Beatlemania, we feature our flag and majorette lines to the next tune. From the album Please Please Me, here is I Saw Her Standing There. Concludes its halftime show with the playing of the Russellville High School fight song.
Changed a lot over the years. If your Pride and Joy has been in an accident or just needs restoration, you need a team of specialists with the up-to-date knowledge and equipment to do the job right. At Advanced Collision Solutions, our team is certified as ICAR Gold Class Professionals to restore all kinds of vehicles, from antiques to RVs, and we guarantee our service with a lifetime warranty. So choose the right solution. Choose Advanced Collision Solutions.
At C&D Drugstore, we strive for the best hometown service we can give. Locally owned and operated since the late 1800s, C&D Drugstore is one of the oldest established drugstores in Arkansas. At C&D Drugstore, we accept all Medicare Part D and offer free delivery. We offer custom compounding and custom flavors for all your prescription needs. So come let our highly trained pharmacy staff assist you and enjoy the snack bar while you wait. C&D Drugstore, 968-2456.
I'm back in my old school to talk about Suddenlink digital cable and high-speed internet. That's my fifth grade teacher, Mrs. Panucci.
Michael, you still owe me that paper on horseshoe crabs.
Sure thing, Mrs. Panucci, but right now I'm giving an oral presentation about Suddenlink.
There's tons of educational shows, and their internet speeds are the fastest in town.
Michael!
I gotta go, but call Suddenlink.
Get Suddenlink 4 meg preferred high-speed internet, now only $29.95 a month for your first 4 months.
When you're looking for a pre-owned vehicle, Valley Motors offers the best selection in the River Valley. Only the cleanest vehicles that have passed the Carfax report and are silver certified 70-point inspection are waiting for you. Plus, we have a large selection of vehicles getting 30 miles per gallon or more. Knowledgeable, friendly salespeople, the best selection, prices starting at $49.95, and easy financing are all at Valley Motors Pre-Owned Center, your friends in the car business, Highway 64 East in Russellville.
Good first half by the Cyclones. They come out now to decide who's going to do what for the second half. Remember, Russell kicked off and went on defense to begin the ball game. So a little discussion there about what they want to do to start the second half. I think North Little Rock has the option what they want to do. A good first half by the Cyclones. It could have been more. But the Cyclones do lead 10-0. North Little Rock had its best offensive series right there at the end of the half. So you have to be mindful they're about to get the engine going, you feel like. So let's see what the officials decide now, or the teams have actually decided. Russell will receive this time and defend the North goal. So this time the offense will have it first. As we get set for the start of the second half, Russell leads 10-0 over the North Little Rock Charging Wildcats, trying to gain their first conference victory of the 2008 season. And a tough conference. A lot of people, of course, say that the 7A West is really tough. That's with Bentonville, Fayetteville, Springdale, Southside High School. But this is a tough conference also here in the Central, with North Little Rock, Russellville, and looming, the Cabot Panthers. Short pickup taken by, that's Jacob Sparks, comes to the near side, getting some running room, got to the 40-yard line. Nice return by Sparks the junior. Stop is made by number 23, Carvis Palmer. He was almost down there around the 16-yard line. Eluded a tackle here. That broke him free. Got a little block there by Bradford Webb. And then turns and makes it as far as he can across the 40. So Russell, first down and 10, good field position, their own 40-yard line, early third period. Hughes. Straight ahead, handoff, and there's just not a whole lot there. Maybe a yard or two gain for Russellville. Kenneth Golden carries the football. Stopped defensively by Colt Schaller, number 91. 1 yard pickup to the 41, second and 9. Both the defenses have played very well. Russellville has been able to get a 24-yard field goal in the first half and a 37-yard touchdown pass to David Robinson. Trips left. Now they bring Golden into the slot and bring Jacob Sparks back into the backfield. Hughes wants to throw near his side, gets it. Ooh, boy, really pasted was Kenneth Golden. Over there making the tackle, Carvis Palmer, 5'8", 155 senior, number 23. And that gain out to the 45-yard line, just beyond the 45. Almost the 46. Third down and a short five for the Cyclones near midfield. As Gebhard goes to the far side, along with two other Cyclone wide receivers. Kenneth Golden in the backfield. Now they flip-flop and bring Jacob Sparks back into the backfield along with Hughes. He's going to get the little screen pass, eludes the first one, the second one. Nice move by Sparks just to keep himself upright and moving forward. There were a lot of white jerseys out there, and finally putting the finishing touch on him was Colby Miller, number four. But Sparks, tough little booger to bring down, 5'6", 155, but brings up fourth down, and the Cyclones will have to punt the football away, leading 10-0. Early third quarter, Zach Hocker, who has a field goal tonight, will be in punt position. And the kick, a driving kick. Going to be returned. That's Donald James, and James going to be downed right there as you see him. Josh Morosco is over there. There's Stephen Gebhard over there, and also Jacob Sparks. So at the 30, just beyond the 30, first down and 10 for North Little Rock. One of the few times that the Charging Wildcats have not had to start at their own 20. 10-0. Cyclones, third period. Cyclones have dominated things, and the game has been dominated by both defenses. Give it off. That is Tillman, number eight. Short pickup, about three or four. Josh Morosco, David Stewart at the bottom of that pile. Place the football at the 33. Picked up two, second down and eight. As again, they give it to the halfback. Really, the slot back's a kind of a slot reverse with the short fullback. Twin slots. Gave it off to the fullback, and that was number 28, Jamar Davis. Very short gain. Jared Vinson made the stop, and he was up there by Grant Michener, number 36. Gained across the 35 to the 36-yard line. Third down, and better than four to go for the first down. Got to get beyond the 40. Twin slots once again, wide receiver right. Back, Hope wants to throw and has a man, and he's got it. Has a nice grab. Wide receiver D'Angelo Mabry reaching up there for that grab and a first down for North Little Rock. Best offensive play of the night from the Charging Wildcats right there. So the gain inside the 40 to near the 38-yard line. Nice throw and catch. Hope from the double slot. Give it off, sweep near side, and not much there for Devontae Rich, number one. Jared Vinson, Kitchens, Michener all there to make the stop. Gain to the 37-yard line. 2-yard pickup, second and eight. Third period, still 10-0. The Cyclones lead. All those points came in the first half. Cyclones trying to get their conference season off to a good start here after winning three non-conference games. But now it's for real. Twin slots, single setback, and going to have a timeout on the field. Timeout North Little Rock, I believe. as they get an opportunity to gather around head coach Brad Boulding to decide what they want to do next. Back in a moment.
If you had someone build you a deck, you'd want them to use the best materials. If you had someone build you a pool, you'd want them to use the best materials. If you had someone install your roof, you'd want them to use award-winning GAF materials. Miller Roofing Company is the only GAF-certified roofing company in the River Valley. Miller Roofing Company is the only one that accepts credit cards and offers financing. Don't settle for anything but the best. Don't settle for anyone but Miller Roofing Company, serving the River Valley for over 24 years.
Though I've been actively involved in public service for several years, I find that family life plays a critical role in preparing me to be your state representative. Families deal with budgets every day, and things like jobs and safety are paramount to us. We know education is the key to success, and that we all have to work together for the good of all.
Families, they can teach us a lot about the right paths in life. As your next state representative, I'll bring my collective public service and practical experience to the state capitol.
Are you ready to score a touchdown on the new Toyota? I'm Randy Cox of Phil Wright Toyota in Russellville. And if you want to shop at a dealership where you have a comfortable hometown atmosphere,
where you're treated with respect and allowed to make an intelligent decision about the car that is right for your needs without being pushed,
where we never have any bogus charges just for doing your paperwork,
a dealership that offers great prices without all the tricky advertising gimmicks,
come see Joel, Michael, or Heath, or visit us online at www.philwrighttoyota.com.
Cars have changed a lot over the years. If your pride and joy has been in an accident or just needs restoration, you need a team of specialists with the up-to-date knowledge and equipment to do the job right. At Advanced Collision Solutions, our team is certified as iCar Gold Class professionals to restore all kinds of vehicles, from antiques to RVs, and we guarantee our service with a lifetime warranty. So choose the right solution. Choose Advanced Collision Solutions.
.734 left to go and period number three. As you look at the Cyclone stands filled with Cyclone excited Cyclone fans who have seen their Cyclones jump out to 3-0 on the campaign, and a lot better football team than a lot of people thought the Cyclones might have this year. They knew they'd have a lot of good defensive faces. We knew about Kenneth Golden. We knew about the other running back in Jason Walker, but the question marks were at quarterback. That has really been answered with Barrett Hughes, and even when Blake Robinson has been playing. There were some questions about wide receiver, and David Robinson has really answered a lot of those questions. So this coaching staff and the kids themselves have really responded. Back, Hope wants to throw, fires out to the 40, 35, to the 30-yard line, or nearly to the 30-yard line. The catch made by D'Angelo Mabry, number 11. Number 16, Lucas Frazee, made the stop. And the gain to just outside the 30-yard line, third down and two. Really, the charging Wildcats have done just about as good throwing the football here in the second half as they have anything else. They like to run the football first, but twin right, twin left from the shotgun. Give it off straight ahead. Nice run there. Turned in by number 28, Jamar Davis. Kitchens makes the stop. It's a first down for North Little Rock, just straight ahead blocking. And a nice run brings David Stewart back into the Cyclone defensive line. Football inside the Russellville 18. Deepest penetration by North Little Rock this evening. Twins left, twins right. Cyclones lead 10-0, and how important was that almost touchdown just before half? Give it off one time again, and that is Jamar Davis. Jamar Davis on the carry. Trent Leslie, number 41, made the stop at the 15 or just outside the 15-yard line. Midway through period number three, 10-0 Cyclones. This defense has played a lot tonight. You just worry about them getting a little tired as the second half rolls on. Twin receivers go left. Twin receivers right. From the shotgun now, David Hope. Wants to throw. Fires! Incomplete. Looked like that pass was intended for Darius Walton, number 83, but it was a little wide of the target. So the clock stops. You see the chain gang over there. Third down and seven for North Little Rock, just outside the 15-yard line. They can get a first down and make it first and goal to goal without scoring the touchdown. Twin receivers right and left from the shotgun. North Little Rock has gone to more of a spread offense here in the last few minutes. Give it off to Tillman. Tillman to the 10 to the 8-yard line, and he is looks like he had enough for the first down. Nice run. Cyclones were guessing pass, and they gave it off to Tillman. 175-pound running back. And that will be a first and goal. No, it isn't. Not quite. Fourth down and a yard. Thought that was going to be first and goal, but they lack almost a yard. You hear those cowbells going. The Cyclones urging their defense on, with the Cyclones leading 10-0. Power eye formation, power right. Give it off. And straight ahead, Devontae Rich, number one, down around the 6-yard line. That should be enough for first and goal. It is. ...160-pound tailback Devontae Rich that particular time. Got a lot of upfront blocking. And it's first and goal at the 6-yard line for the charging Wildcats, who have not even been close to scoring till now. Power eye formation, power right. Quick pitch. And down and in for the touchdown is Devontae Rich. Scoring from 6 yards out, got some good offensive blocking, particularly from the backs in front of him. And North Little Rock has gotten themselves on the scoreboard and tightened this game up at 10-6. The extra point would move it to a 10-7 ball game. So hold on to your hats. The Cyclones had dominated things, but now North Little Rock has taken the football and going right down the field, and they are back in this one. The snap and the kick, and it is good. 10-7 our score. We'll be right back.
Want more life per gallon? Then Valley Motors is your best buy. With over one-third of our pre-owned inventory getting 30 miles per gallon and cars and trucks beginning at only $178 per month, it is a win-win situation for you. Plus, Valley Motors' goal is to finance everyone with the best rates, the best warranties, and the peace of mind in buying a quality certified pre-owned vehicle. That's Valley Motors, Highway 64 East in Russellville. Your friends in the car business.
So how you like driving that thing?
It's intense.
Expensive to insure?
No. Went with Nationwide, saved like $500.
$500?
Yeah, it's great coverage.
Really? I didn't know Nationwide did that.
Life comes at you fast. With Nationwide, you could save like $500 on your auto insurance.
Contact Chris Lamberson at 968-8698.
Nationwide is on your side.
Huh. Have you looked closely at the rate on your interest-bearing checking account? What about the account benefits? Are you getting the rewards you deserve? Maybe it's time to check out reward checking, offered exclusively at First State Bank, the only bank in the market paying higher interest checking. Plus, you get same-day posting and refunds on your foreign ATM fees. We'll also include free online banking with bill pay. Don't settle for second-best checking when you can have reward checking from First State Bank, your true community bank.
Are you ready to score a touchdown on the new Toyota? I'm Randy Cox of Philwright Toyota in Russellville. And if you want to shop at a dealership where you have a comfortable hometown atmosphere,
where you are treated with respect and allowed to make an intelligent decision about the car that is right for your needs without being pushed.
Where we never have any bogus charges just for doing your paperwork.
A dealership that offers great prices without all the tricky advertising gimmicks.
Come see Joel, Michael, or Heath, or visit us online at www.fillrighttoyota.com.
.434 left to go. Third period. Cyclones lead. That was 10-0. Now only 10-7. So the Cyclones need to put a few more points on the board. You have the feeling that a 10-0 lead is never safe because the touchdown puts you right back in it. A field goal ties it. The second touchdown puts you ahead. So Cyclones need to answer now this North Little Rock touchdown on this offensive drive here, getting into the latter stages of the third period. So the kickoff coming from the charging Wildcats, the kicker is Kyle Cromer, number 84. He's a senior, 5'11", 180. Let's see if it's returnable. And it will be from the 12-yard line. And a nice return. Turned in by Jacob Sparks. Boy, he gets moving in a hurry. Stop made defensively by Micah Mellon, a senior defensive end, 175-pounder, at the 30-yard line. First down and 10, but one of the poorer field position starts for the Cyclones offensively, leading now only 10-7. You see Demarius Neal, the junior, check into the lineup. He's a tight end on the left-hand side of the offensive line, not your left-hand side as you look at the screen. I formation in the backfield. Give it off. Golden. Golden may have gotten back to the line of scrimmage, and that's about all. He slipped down as he swept the left side. Over there to make sure he stayed down was the defensive end, Ryan Franklin, number 80. No gain. Again, the Cyclones, who were rolling along, pretty well dominating the whole football game, although mostly on the defensive side of the football, leading 10-0. Then North Little Rock gets their drive together, got themselves together, and scored to make it 10-7. Hughes throws out, and it's complete to Stephen Gebhard, about a 3-yard pickup, about the 33. And the stop made defensively by Carvis Palmer, the senior, 155-pounder. Well, they give the forward progress for Gebhard out to the 34. Third down and 6. And you hope to string together some first downs here. Number one, to let your defense have some rest. And number two, take some time off the clock. And number three, to try to put some points on the board. Number four, to give yourself good field position if you have to punt. Trips left. Back to throw. And he fires. It is complete. Oh, a nice throw and catch, but also a big hit there. Stephen Gebhard making the reception. And it's enough for a first down. Back. Hughes stood his ground, delivered the football, and then kaboom. There's two hits. Whoa, man. And the second one probably worse than the first. That one turned in by defensive back James Sheerans. Give it off to Golden. Golden sweeps left side, and the carry is out to the 42, the 43-yard line. Well, let's make that across midfield to the 48-yard line, maybe the 47 of North Little Rock. As we look at it, second down and 6. .10-7 the score, third quarter. at the 48-yard line. Hand it off, and that is Walker. Walker with a big gain. Down the sideline, Jason Walker could go all the way. Finally drug down from behind inside the 10. Nice run by Jason Walker. Look at the delayed handoff. Took a little sidestep here to the left, and then just turned it on. And he outran everybody. Finally dragging him down was James Sheeran's number 26. So it's a first down for the Cyclones, trying to answer that North Little Rock touchdown. Under center now. Barrett Hughes hands it off. And Golden able to slide his way forward a little bit. Not much running room there. Dropped by number 53, Anthony Rogers. And number 91, that's Colt Schaller. Down to about the 5-yard line. Second and goal at the 5. Gebhard split right. Golden, single setback behind Hughes. Play action fake. Throwing. Complete, and the touchdown to the tight end. Nice grab there by number 23, Demarius Neal. Let's look at it again. Fake it to Golden, who sweeps left. Hughes, great focus there, and finds a diving tight end, Demarius Neal, for the touchdown. He's excited. Demarius, junior, 225-pounder, makes it 16-7. 16-7 here near the end of period number 3. Hocker on for the extra point kick. It's in the air, and the kick is good. 17-7, the Cyclones extend their lead back to 10 points again with 1:14 to go, period number 3.
Danny Cawthorn wants to be your next Polk County Sheriff. He has 16 years of law enforcement background and experience, was hired as a Polk County deputy in 1974, is a Vietnam veteran who served with the 101st Airborne, the owner of a successful Polk County small business. Danny Cawthorn, your choice for Polk County Sheriff.
Hi, I'm Danny Cawthorn, and I'd like to be your next sheriff.
We want you to vote for Danny.
Life comes at you fast, but with Nationwide Blue Ribbon Claim Services, you don't have to worry if your car's been in an accident.
Contact Chris Lamberson at 968-8698.
Nationwide is on your side.
If you had someone build you a deck, you'd want them to use the best materials. If you had someone build you a pool, you'd want them to use the best materials. If you had someone install your roof, you'd want them to use award-winning GAF materials. Miller Roofing Company is the only GAF-certified roofing company in the River Valley. Miller Roofing Company is the only one that accepts credit cards and offers financing. Don't settle for anything but the best. Don't settle for anyone but Miller Roofing Company, serving the River Valley for over 24 years.
As a kid, we had that encyclopedia from 1976, and I'd be like, why isn't the space shuttle in here? Today, students learn so much on the internet. They listen to famous speeches, and they look at that cat. That's why suddenly high-speed internet's great. There's no required contracts, and with connections that are faster than DSL, you'll know it's not 1976. Now that's groovy.
Get Suddenlink Value High-Speed Internet. Enjoy 1 meg of download speed for only $19.95 a month for your first 4 months.
Well, a 70-yard drive, and of course the Jason Walker run, the big play. Nice job by the senior running back, 175-pounder. We've talked so much about Kenneth Golden and what a job Golden has done, but the Cyclones have a good stable of running backs with, of course, Jason Walker, and we've also seen Jacob Sparks this evening. So head coach Jeff Holt has got quite a number of weapons at that running back position. So here's Hocker to kick off. He has a 24-yard field goal this evening. So Hocker will kick it away. And the kick in the air. Taken at the goal line, and he stepped back in there again. Donald James was trying so hard to stay out of the end zone. But he couldn't do so, and North Little Rock will have it at their own 20-yard line. First down and 10. So at the 20, first down 10, and now the Cyclone defense has had a little chance to rest, so maybe that's good. Hopefully that's good. Leading 17-7, final seconds of the third quarter. Hope under pressure unloads and overthrown. Pass was intended for D'Angelo Mabry. He actually threw it into the North Little Rock bench. Mabry tried to make the adjustment as the ball came down a little, actually underthrown for the receiver, but out of bounds. Second down. For North Little Rock. Twin receivers right, twin receivers left. In the shotgun now, David Hope. Keeps it himself. Goes right. Ooh, hit hard there. Fell forward close to first down yardage. But Hope calling his number for the first time, really, as a runner this evening. Josh Morosco looks like they're holding his right arm after that play. But third down and less than a yard. Give it off. And enough for the first down. That carry went to Jamar Davis. And it's a first down for North Little Rock. Cyclones lead 17-7. At the 33-yard line. Just as North Little Rock thought they were back into it, the Cyclones put together that big 70-yard drive and have eased out to a 10-point lead once again. But nothing ever comfortable against any of your conference opponents particularly. Hope from the shotgun. Wants to throw, fires, that's complete. That to D'Angelo Mabry. And that's the end of the third quarter. With our score, Cyclone 17, North Little Rock 7. We'll be back for the fourth period in just a moment.
Are you ready to score a touchdown on the new Toyota? I'm Randy Cox, Phil Wright Toyota in Russellville. And if you want to shop at a dealership where you have a comfortable, hometown atmosphere,
where you're treated with respect and allowed to make an intelligent decision about the car that is right for your needs without being pushed,
where we never have any bogus charges just for doing your paperwork,
a dealership that offers great prices without all the tricky advertising gimmicks,
come see Joel, Michael, or Heath, or visit us online at www.philwrighttoyota.com.
Cars have changed a lot over the years. If your pride and joy has been in an accident or just needs restoration, you need a team of specialists with the up-to-date knowledge and equipment to do the job right. At Advanced Collision Solutions, our team is certified as ICAR Gold Class Professionals to restore all kinds of vehicles, from antiques to RVs, and we guarantee our service with a lifetime warranty. So choose the right solution. Choose Advanced Collision Solutions.
Store, we strive for the best hometown service we can give. Locally owned and operated since the late 1800s, C&D Drugstore is one of the oldest established drugstores in Arkansas. At C&D Drugstore, we accept all Medicare Part D and offer free delivery. We offer custom compounding and custom flavors for all your prescription needs. So come let our highly trained pharmacy staff assist you and enjoy the snack bar while you wait. C&D Drugstore, 968-2456.
Time for a big fourth quarter for the Cyclones to notch their first conference victory of the year. And also to go to 4-0 on the year and remain ranked in the top 10 in the state of Arkansas. And that's, of course, a lot like a lot of coaches say, and I'm sure Coach Holt would echo this. The polls are good for the fans, but the only real true poll is the one at the end of the year. After you've gone and made yourself a conference champion, you've made yourself to the state playoffs, and you've done all that you can do in that, that's when the polls count. The rest of it is just for the fans and kind of give you something to eyeball throughout the year. But the thing about the polls, we've already seen this in the college ranks, is that, if you're number one, you got a target on your back, and everybody looks to see who in the top 10 gets knocked off next. So back to throw, Horn fires, and it is complete. Oh, juggling the football, but able to hold on across the 45, out about the 48-yard line. Josh Morosco made the stop. The receiver was Jamar Davis. But the polls are a lot of fun. I like watching them also, just to see who's doing well and who the quote-unquote experts think of the top teams in the state or in the nation. Give it off to the fullback. A fullback rambling his way down to the 42-yard line of Russellville, and that was the fullback, Jamar Davis. He's not a big guy, 5'6", 170. But a good carry for a first down, and North Little Rock is moving. Boy, that last touchdown was really important to get that one in the end zone, because North Little Rock is beginning to get things together here now, and they have played a lot better offensively in the second half. Back, Horn, whoop, fakes, he's going to go downtown, got a man there, and it's there, and that's a touchdown, I believe. It is. He kind of juggled it as he was going across the goal line, but again, number 83, Darius Walton. Nice, nice reception. Juggled it again, but was able to keep hold of it, and look at all the time that's left. 11-12 to go in the football game, and North Little Rock back within four, and an extra point will make it three. It's up, and the kick, it is good. 17-14. Oh, here we go. Brand new ball game as the Cyclones holding on to a three-point lead here at Cyclone Stadium.
I'm back in my old school to talk about Suddenlink digital cable and high-speed internet.
That's my fifth grade teacher, Mrs. Panucci.
Michael, you still owe me that paper on horseshoe crabs.
Sure thing, Mrs. Panucci, but right now I'm giving an oral presentation about Suddenlink.
There's tons of educational shows, and their internet speeds are the fastest in town.
Michael!
I gotta go.
but call Suddenlink.
Get Suddenlink 4 meg preferred high-speed internet. Now only $29.95 a month for your first 4 months.
When you're looking for a pre-owned vehicle, Valley Motors offers the best selection in the River Valley. Only the cleanest vehicles that have passed a Carfax report and our silver-certified 70-point inspection are waiting for you. Plus, we have a large selection of vehicles getting 30 miles per gallon or more. Knowledgeable, friendly salespeople, the best selection, prices starting at $49.95, and easy financing are all at Valley Motors Pre-Owned Center, your friends in the car business. Highway 64 East in Russellville.
It's really cute. Don't you love the sunroof?
Yeah, especially this time of year.
How's the insurance on it?
You won't believe. I went with Nationwide and saved like $500.
$500?
Yeah. Coverage is great.
Huh. I didn't know Nationwide did that.
Life comes at you fast. With Nationwide, you could save like $500 on your auto insurance.
Contact Chris Lamberson at 968-8698.
Nationwide is on your side.
Are you ready to score a touchdown on the new Toyota? I'm Randy Cox, Phil Wright Toyota in Russellville. And if you want to shop at a dealership where you have a comfortable, hometown atmosphere,
where you're treated with respect and allowed to make an intelligent decision about the car that is right for your needs without being pushed,
where we never have any bogus charges just for doing your paperwork,
a dealership that offers great prices without all the tricky advertising gimmicks,
come see Joel, Michael, or Heath, or visit us online at www.philwrighttoyota.com.
.17-14 our score. And the Cyclones now will have to be very protective. Now, they answered the last time that North Little Rock scored. And isn't it interesting that North Little Rock was so intent on the run for most of the first half and just could not do anything. Now they've gone to the air a lot more, a bigger percentage of the time, and they have had some success. But the Cyclones were able to answer the last time North Little Rock scored and put another TD on the board to extend it to a 10-point lead. They could use that again here. The kicker, Kyle Cromer, ready to boot the football away. A driving kick could be taken. That's Jacob Sparks, 20, 25-yard line out about the 26 before he's tripped up. Over there defensively, number 5, Jason Ferry, number 5. So the Cyclones offense now, the idea is run clock, keep the chains moving, put the ball in the end zone. And apparently we have a hanky on the ground. And the march off is going to be against North Little Rock. It is 5 yards, apparently for an inadvertent face mask penalty. So just 5 yards, but the Cyclones get a little bit further upfield. Barrett Hughes checks in the junior. What an outstanding job he has done. Three wide receivers right. Give it off. Golden. Not much for Golden there. Dropped by the defensive end, Brian McCleary. He's 6 foot, 220 pounds at defensive end. And for both teams, the running up the middle, the run game particularly, with a few exceptions, has been difficult. Russell has the big run by Jason Walker. Three wide receivers split right. Single setback in the backfield with the quarterback in the shotgun. Barrett Hughes, he wants to throw, looks right, fires right, has the man. Oh, and what a hit. Oh, my goodness. Let's look at that again. Did anybody get the number of that truck? The catch made, and oh, what a delivery made there. Everybody's all right, but I mean, that's like running full speed into a brick wall. So happily, everybody is still alive after that train wreck. And it was a completed pass out to the 38-yard line. Send Golden right. Back. Hughes under pressure. Now fires underneath. And incomplete. Tending it for Tanner Keeling, and a ball popped loose. He tried to catch it down around the shoe tops. So it brings up fourth down. And the Cyclones, unfortunately, are going to have to punt the football away, and that is not what head coach Jeff Holt and the Cyclones wanted to do here. They wanted to hold on to the football, keep the chains moving, if not scoring, get the football on the other end of the field and pin North Little Rock deep. But now North Little Rock's going to get at least fair field position and a lot of time left on the clock. Hawker's kick. And it's a dandy ooh, and James had to fall to corral that one around the 31-yard line. So North Little Rock has, we'll call it fair field position. They've most of the time tonight been starting around their own 20, but the dangerous thing is they do have the football, and they're only behind the Cyclones by 3 here in the fourth period. So the defense has got to rise to the occasion now. That's Terrell Carter and David Stewart and the whole group. Hope from the shotgun. Oh, he dropped the football and he just has to fall on it. That was fortunate for the Cyclones. Fell on it back at the 25. That'll be a 6-yard loss. And that was Hope's fault. He really got a hand on that, David Hope, the quarterback. But he just couldn't corral it in, and it was like it had butter on it, and he just very wisely was laying out there and very wisely fell on it to make sure that the Cyclones didn't fall on it at the 25-yard line. Twin wide receivers left and twin to the near side. That's the almost the bottom left of your screen. Back. Hope off that back foot, incomplete. Couldn't really deliver it forward. He was under pressure. The pass was intended for Devontae Rich. And back at the 25-yard line, third down, and about 16. So the Cyclones face with a big third down play here to stop North Little Rock and get the ball back. Twins left and right once again. Under pressure, down the middle. Hope throws to that fullback. Good running room there out to the 40 and very close to the first down. The fullback, Jamar Davis, caught the little screen pass, and the officials are going to measure. It is very close. Good call by the North Little Rock coaching staff. Cyclones had the blitz on, and North Little Rock took advantage of it by going over the middle to the fullback, Jamar Davis. They stretched the chain, and it's short. So it's going to be a fourth down and less, well, about a foot. Well, will North Little Rock go for it here? The sideline, they make a motion like they want their fans to get into it, so apparently they're going to go for it on fourth down. And it being the fourth quarter, that would be a logical assumption here. Football at the 40 and a half. They've got to get about another half for the first down. Cyclone defense digs in. Give it off to the fullback, or I should say the quarterback keeps it. That is Hope. And it looks like he has enough for the first down. And North Little Rock clapping their hands about that as they keep the chains moving. Not much of a gain, but enough to keep the ball in North Little Rock's hands. David Hope just kept it. Very safe play. Had only about 6 inches to pick up, and he did that. Twin receivers left and twin receivers right. Hope gave it off to the first man. That's Jamar Davis. And I'll tell you what, I thought he left a little early. That was almost like the Canadian football league or arena football. He was starting back there and getting a full burst of speed up before he got to the quarterback. Gain of one, second and nine. But it really looked like he took off early. And we saw Tillman mainly in the first half. Here in the second half, they have gone almost completely with Jamar Davis. Back, Hope wants to throw, fires, and it's complete. Let's see where they mark his forward progress. Pass was complete to Devontae Rich. And the gain up to the 48-yard line brings up a third down and four. Another big third down play for the Cyclones. Last time, North Little Rock threw a screen pass and picked up 15 and a half of the 16 yards they needed and then went on fourth down. Offset eye, power eye in the backfield. Quick pitch. This is Tillman trying to sweep the left side. And looks like he's going to make it, except there's a yellow flag down on the play. Bradford Webb was over there to make the stop. And Tillman, not happy. It's going to be holding against North Little Rock. Somebody out there ahead of Tillman was holding. And Tillman picked up enough for the first down, but it's going to be wiped out and brought back. And that's a big play for the Cyclones defensively. Mistake for North Little Rock at a critical stage of this ball game. Midway through the fourth period, and the Cyclones clinging to a 17-14 lead over the charging Wildcats. Again, a big thank you to our great sponsors who are with us throughout the year. And thanks for you watching. Please spread the word. And I appreciate all of you who have been stopping me at gas stations and at the grocery store and saying how much you enjoy the television broadcasts. And enjoying the professional games that you're getting with the instant replay and the ground level shots and all that. Back, Hope wants to throw. He's under trouble. Forced out of the pocket. Throws on the run. Incomplete. Again, the intended receiver was Devontae Rich, but Hope was running for his life. Trying to thread the needle down the near sideline, and it just fell incomplete. Just lucky for Hope that he was able to not get sacked. And the punt unit comes on to the field for the charging Wildcats. Devontae Rich to punt the football. He stands back at his own 25, inside his 25. Good snap and a good kick. And the ball is going to just really bound it almost straight up in the air. Down there by North Little Rock. That was Hunter Hess, number 58, offensive lineman who downed the football. Cyclones will have it about the 33-yard line. First down and 10. Latter stages of the fourth period on IMC Studios Sports Watch. You can see this game three times every Sunday night. See your favorite players, see the great games. I mean, you know, there's lots of great football on television, but this is also some of the best TV football you can see. Barrett Hughes gives it off to Jason Walker. Boy, there was nothing there. Woo! Boy, oh boy. Big number 79 leading the charge there. 330-pound Darius Hudson. And Walker saw that almost immediately, that there was just a wall there. Darius Hudson, you can see, is back there, number 79. That is a wide load. 17-14, second down, still about 10 or a little bit more. Three wide receivers split right. Bring a man in motion, that's back into the backfield. Comes Sparks. Stepping up, Hughes throws on the run, complete! Out to midfield. Beautiful job of knowing where he is and under pressure. Hughes steps up, almost brought down and throws on the run, a little floater. got it to David Robinson, and Robinson forced forward. Really, he was trying to get down, but forced forward to midfield. And it seems like when you need the big catch, there he is, David Robinson. Did it again. Football right at midfield, first down. Keeps the clock moving, keeps the ball in the Cyclones' hands. Throw it out to Haley. Haley, just back to the line of scrimmage. That's all he can get. 91, Colt Schaller. And over there also was number 80, Ryan Franklin. No gain on the play, second and 10 at midfield. But the best thing is the clock is moving and the Cyclones have the football and they have the lead 17-14. Robinson goes split right. Steven Gebhard comes split left. Haley in the slot near side. Hughes. And timeout for the Cyclones. They want to talk it over here. Something head coach Jeff Holt saw wasn't just to his liking, so he wants to make sure everybody's on the same page. No mistakes here. Well, as they huddle and talk about it, we'll take a slight break. Cyclones lead 17-14 back in a moment.
Shop for a cause at Mistletoe Market, a holiday shopping event benefiting the Boys and Girls Clubs of the River Valley. Friday and Saturday, October 10th and 11th from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. at the L.V. Williamson Boys and Girls Club in Russellville. Call 968-7819.
Are you ready to score a touchdown on the new Toyota? I'm Randy Cox at Philwright Toyota in Russellville. And if you want to shop at a dealership where you have a comfortable hometown atmosphere,
where you are treated with respect and allowed to make an intelligent decision about the car that is right for your needs without being pushed,
where we never have any bogus charges just for doing your paperwork,
a dealership that offers great prices without all the tricky advertising gimmicks,
come see Joel, Michael, or Heath, or visit us online at www.philwrighttoyota.com.
CenturyTel high-speed internet, $14.95 a month when you bundle. Think fast.
Well, there it is, 4:05 to go in this one, 17-14. You feel like if the Cyclones can string together a couple more first downs, they ought to be in pretty good shape, but you just don't know. It's still nail-biting time here. There's the Cyclone band. Mr. Dove and his whole crew. I was talking to my good friend Bill Spainauer, who is with the North Little Rock Band. He used to be with the Dardanelle program. And, of course, a former tech bandsman. And he said, year after year, he said, you can always count on the Cyclone Band being the best in the state. So, Barrett Hughes. Twin right, twin left. 4:05 to play. Looked like North Little Rock was going to bring the blitz, but it not happening. And the pass complete to the 40-yard line. Nice throw and grab. As Hughes, looking, quickly throws, hits Stephen Gebhard. And it should be a first down. The tackle made by Jason Ferry, number 5. First down for the Cyclones at the 40, keeping the chains moving, keeping the ball with them. Time now, as the old song says, time is on your side for the Cyclones. Twins right. In the slot. Turn, give it off. Oh, a nice move there. Not anything forward, but to avoid a loss, Kenneth Golden. Stop made defensively. Guy, we've called his name a lot tonight, Brian McCleary, the defensive end. He's a good one, 6 foot, 220-pounder. North Little Rock, this is a good football team. They didn't have much offense in the first half, done more offensively in the second half, and a lot of it running the football. Passing the football. They did not have much success running the football in the first half. Had a lot more success passing, and they went to a more pass-oriented offense in the second half. Hughes under pressure. He's going to step up again. Now throws incomplete. He should have run it. Probably should have gone ahead and run for a little more yards, trying to find Tanner Keeling. He was defended by Ryan Franklin, the defensive end, number 80. And I think Hughes had a notion to run, but then he saw Keeling open. He just couldn't get the ball to him. 17-14, fourth period, and the last stages of that. Will the Cyclones remain undefeated? Will they pick up their first conference victory? The next 4 or 5 minutes are going to tell us the answers to those questions. Trips right. And now the Cyclones are going to call timeout. Again, I guess coaching staff said, boys, that whatever they were lining up in just wasn't exactly what they wanted to do. And head coach Jeff Holt, with a timeout to burn, said, let's just make sure we're all on the same page here. Critical part of the ball game, 17-14. We'll be back for the final moments after this.
The internet and e-commerce are radically changing the way consumers are spending their money. In fact, a recent U.S. Department of Commerce study shows a 27% increase year over year in internet e-commerce spending, and they expect $117 billion to be spent every year on the internet by 2008. IMC Studios has proven web design and internet e-commerce solutions to help you put your business's products on the internet for a global market. We've been serving the River Valley for over 10 years.
When you're looking for a pre-owned vehicle, Valley Motors offers the best selection in the River Valley. Only the cleanest vehicles that have passed the Carfax report and our silver certified 70-point inspection are waiting for you. Plus, we have a large selection of vehicles getting 30 miles per gallon or more. Knowledgeable, friendly salespeople, the best selection, prices starting at $49.95, and easy financing are all at Valley Motors Pre-Owned Center, your friends in the car business. Highway 64 East in Russellville.
Oh, some great moves there from the Cyclone cheerleaders, as they do every week. Sorrell's Body Shop, Liberty Bank, Energy, Innovative Industrial Solutions, Incorporated Turnkey Business Systems, Posey Printing and Marketing Company, Simmons Bank, Valley Motors, EADS North America, Doctors Johnston and Richardson, and St. Mary's Regional Medical Center, we salute you and thank you for being sponsors of Cyclone Football. At the 40. Will the Cyclones hold on to the football here? Hughes delivers. Boy, it is intercepted. Could be a touchdown. Oh, he tripped. He fell over his own feet. That was the defensive end. Ryan Franklin. And I really think he was getting ready to score, because there was not anybody real close to him. Some of the Cyclones might have gotten an angle in the next 10 yards and brought him down before the touchdown, but that really looked like that Ryan Franklin, after he picked that one off, was going to... Oh, we have one of the officials that got shaken up a little bit. But that one took a moment to sort out, and finally, Ryan Franklin came up with the football. He returns it to the 31-yard line, and how he didn't score, I don't know. He cut back, trying to go to the center of the field, and he slipped down. Otherwise, that should have been a touchdown and would have been the touchdown that gave North Little Rock the lead. But now, the Cyclone defense got their work cut out for them with their backs to the wall at the 31. Give it off. Oh, and the fullback Davis, nothing doing there. Jared Vinson. Look at this. Just as he gets to the hole, there are two Cyclones there that say nothing doing. Trent Leslie also in on the play, and I think that's Terrell Carter also. Hello, Mr. Davis. twin receivers right. And if North Little Rock thinks they're going to score here, they're going to have to almost positively, they'll have to do it through the air. I don't think they'll do it on the ground. Hope, he is hit to the end zone. It is intercepted by Marasco. Nobody even close. The ball came up short. And the interception gives it back to the Cyclones at the 11. We couldn't see it in the picture, but I think there was a receiver that was deeper. And just by the time Hope delivered, he got hit, and the ball came up short, and Marasco picked it off. Big turnaround there gives the football back to the Cyclones, and finally wrestling him down was Donald James. So the teams trade turnovers, and there is the big factor right there, 1:51 on the clock. Now, if the Cyclones can somehow get a first down, I think that they can run the clock out. But the main thing is they have the football, and they can thank the turf, maybe, for still being in the lead. Give the ball off. Kenneth Golden just trying to eke out a little yardage here. Gain of two on the play. Stop made defensively by big number 91, Colt Schaller, 225-pounder. And North Little Rock calls a timeout. Well, we need to catch our breath also. Cyclones clinging to a 17-14 lead after the interception. Back after this.
Smith, Brown 11.7 rebounds in the contest. Smith lost it going inside. Now it's Martin. Blew the dunk. Ball tipped away by Smith.
Back and down. No defensive help.
Life comes at you fast. With our select coverage options, a nationwide agent can tailor a home policy just for you.
Contact Chris Lamberson at 968-8698.
Nationwide is on your side.
Well, at this point, I know head coach Jeff Holt is saying, run, clock, run. 1:44 to play. Cyclones clinging to a 17-14 lead. How Ryan Franklin didn't score on his interception return is still a wonder to me. But he slipped down at the 31. The Cyclones follow with an interception of their own by Josh Marasco. They have the football back. They've run one play. And now the Cyclones just trying to give this home crowd something to be thrilled about, a conference victory, and send themselves to 4-0 on the year. But this one is not over yet. High formation, give it off to Golden. Oh, he's got some running room and slips down at the 25. Good offensive blocking here. Look at Golden, cut it back right there. And that made all the difference. Then he slipped down right in front of number 26, James Sheerans. It's a first down for the Cyclones, and that may be all they need. They need to run three plays, and at least three plays to run the clock out. Arthur LaRock digs in there, hoping for a turnover. You know they'll be scrapping for that football. Eye formation behind Barrett Hughes. Give it off to Golden. Golden again finds some running room and able to find the 30-yard line. Stop made by Christian Hooks, number 30. And Arthur LaRock calls and burns another timeout here. 17-14, Cyclones. Looking at the clock. 1:03. 17-14. This is nail-biting time here because you can't afford to put one on the ground. You can't afford to have to punt it back to North Little Rock. Give them an opportunity, even just one heave to the end zone. Need to end it here. And the Cyclone fans know that. There are the cheerleaders and the pep squad on the near sideline trying to keep the spirits up for the Cyclone fans for the final 63 ticks of the clock. And hopeful the Cyclones can hold on and win this one. First half was pretty well all Cyclones. Second half has been pretty well even Steven. North Little Rock got their offensive game a little bit better together. And the knee down by Barrett Hughes. And that will run a few seconds off the clock now. Back at the 28-yard line. They'll let as much time run off that clock as possible before they put the football into play once again. Trying to run this clock down. There with his hands up and down is Demarius Neal, who had the big touchdown catch, sliding to his knees in the end zone that gave the Cyclones the lead. And we have a timeout for the Cyclones. They take a timeout to set the last seconds of play. We'll be back in a moment.
Danny Cawthorn wants to be your next Polk County Sheriff. He has 16 years of law enforcement background and experience, was hired as a Polk County deputy in 1974, is a Vietnam veteran who served with the 101st Airborne, the owner of a successful Polk County small business. Danny Cawthorn, your choice for Polk County Sheriff.
Hi, I'm Danny Cawthorn, and I'd like to be your next sheriff.
We want you to vote for Danny.
Have you looked closely at the rate on your interest-bearing checking account? What about the account benefits? Are you getting the rewards you deserve? Maybe it's time to check out reward checking, offered exclusively at First State Bank, the only bank in the market paying higher interest checking. Plus, you get same-day posting and refunds on your foreign ATM fees. We'll also include free online banking with bill pay. Don't settle for second-best checking when you can have reward checking from First State Bank, your true community bank.
Twenty-six ticks on the clock, and the Cyclones feel like if they can maybe put the knee down one more time, that should be it. Head coach Jeff Holt, I'm sure, talking to his troops about holding on to that football, cover it up. Don't need anything here to cause a turnover that might give North Little Rock a chance here late. 26 seconds left. And this will be a hard-fought, well-deserved victory for the Cyclones. And a conference victory. Hughes steps back and then puts the knee down. And that may be it. Everybody starts congratulating each other, and that'll be it. Because North Little Rock can't stop it, and the Cyclones don't want to stop it. And Russellville will escape, winning this one. After jumping out to a 10-0 lead, they defeat North Little Rock to go to 4-0, 1-0 in conference, in the 7A Central with a 17-14 victory. Congratulations, Cyclones. Thanks for tuning in.
What a great win! What a great win! What a good, solid football team!
Yeah!
They worked.
Having
a great conference battle. 1-0, baby.
Players of the game this week brought to you by Brian Fisher, your Allstate insurance agent. Offensive player of the game, Steven Gebhard. Defensive player of the game, Josh Morasco. Special teams player of the game, Jacob Sparks. The players of the game brought to you by Brian Fisher, your Allstate insurance agent.
Danny Cawthorn wants to be your next Polk County Sheriff. He has 16 years of law enforcement background and experience, was hired as a Polk County Deputy in 1974, is a Vietnam veteran who served with the 101st Airborne, the owner of a successful Polk County small business. Danny Cawthorn, your choice for Polk County Sheriff.
Hi, I'm Danny Cawthorn, and I'd like to be your next sheriff.
We want you to vote for Danny.
Have you looked closely at the rate on your interest-bearing checking account? What about the account benefits? Are you getting the rewards you deserve? Maybe it's time to check out reward checking, offered exclusively at First State Bank, the only bank in the market paying higher interest checking. Plus, you get same-day posting and refunds on your foreign ATM fees. We'll also include free online banking with bill pay. Don't settle for second-best checking when you can have reward checking from First State Bank, your true community bank.
Want more life per gallon? Then Valley Motors is your best buy. With over one-third of our pre-owned inventory getting 30 miles per gallon and cars and trucks beginning at only $178 per month, it is a win-win situation for you. Plus, Valley Motors' goal is to finance everyone with the best rates, the best warranties, and the peace of mind in buying a quality certified pre-owned vehicle. That's Valley Motors, Highway 64 East in Russellville. Your friends in the car business.
So how you like driving that thing?
It's intense.
Expensive to insure?
No. Went with Nationwide, saved like $500.
$500?
Yeah, it's great coverage.
Really? I didn't know Nationwide did that.
Life comes at you fast. With Nationwide, you could save like $500 on your auto insurance.
Contact Chris Lamberson at 968-8698.
Nationwide is on your side.